Hey y'all, how's it going? It is currently day 3, I believe, of me freezing my tits off inside of my own house. It's like 47 degrees outside, which to me, I believe is technically negative 47 degrees below zero. I think that's actually the way it works, right? Conversion from Celsius to Fahrenheit and whatnot. I'm just saying, it's cold as shit and I hate it. I don't know, like how do you survive up north? I'm not trying to be patronizing, I swear, I'm genuinely intrigued. I've actually never been up north. I think the furthest north I've been is like Kentucky. So I genuinely don't know how people survive. I don't understand. Do you have to wear like every item of clothing that you own when you go out? Do you just not go outside from like October to April? Or are you like genetically conditioned to survive in cold weather? Similar, I guess, how I'm conditioned to survive in the heat. I don't know. I'm genuinely intrigued here. Anyway, I'm just saying I'm already sick of it and it's only been cold for like 3 days. So I've got a little bit longer to go before I can escape to the beaches of Maui. And that is kind of what we are talking about today. This is going to be the finale for my makeup basket slash project pan that I have been doing since the beginning of the year. So I know that I just filmed my last update like 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, something like that. But I am going to go ahead and call it now. For one, I've finished the vast majority of what I think I realistically can finish before I leave. Also, kind of some extenuating circumstances. I need to go ahead and do my makeup declutter this coming week. I'm so excited. I hope y'all are too. So I need to go ahead and film that because I need to have my decluttered makeup ready to go by, I don't know, next Friday is like the 26th or something, because I'm going to be giving it to one of my friends who, she's such a good person too, just in general, love her to death, but she has recently taken in a teenage girl who loves makeup, and because this world is a shitty freaking place sometimes, she's never had like a stable home environment and the ability to have even her own little makeup collection for herself. It fucking breaks my heart. Anyway, so it just seems like a perfect opportunity. Here I am. I've got more than I could ever use. I'm about to move. I need to declutter. It's a great opportunity for me to offload some of this stuff, which helps me out too, and for her to receive it. So it is a little bit early, but like I said, I need to go ahead and do it that way when I... Can you stop snazzing in the background? You okay? Got hairball? Got hairball? Sugar has her little sweater on too. She's a Texas dog. I assume she's freezing her tits off too. Anyway, I don't know where I was. Basically, I just need to do this a little bit early, so I'm gonna go ahead and call this project and do my declutter. Stealing the show from me all the time. Gets her little paws and rubs her eyes. Well, I think that's like the cutest thing she does. You know, I don't want to harp on this too much because it's not my story to tell, but I just have to say my friend Pam is her name. She is a single mother on her own, single woman trying to survive in this world. And how she has it in her heart and in her finances, you know, to open her home to someone else, it's just, it's remarkable. And oh, fuck. There really is good in the world. There really is. Like, whatever you're looking for, if you're looking for bad, you will definitely find it. But if you look for the good, there's so many wonderful people too. There truly is. It's just, it is really heartwarming. All right, so let's go ahead and wrap up this project. And I did compile some numbers because I was intrigued to see what this project actually did for me. And I was able to use up 23 products total, makeup products total, and also 9 perfumes. I kind of kept them separately because to me, it's more of an achievement to use up the makeup than a perfume. I can blow through perfume easily. And the totals for those were $366 in makeup alone and an additional $234 in perfume. I did use up other things like mascaras and lip balms and stuff like that that weren't in the project. That will be in my year-long makeup empties. 10-month-long makeup empties this year, but yeah, those are not counted here, only products that I used up because of this project, ones that were included. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the progress that I've made and the products that I've used up since the last update, which, like I said, was about 2.5 weeks ago. And I was able to use up 3 items, most of which were kind of on their last legs at the last update, so I knew it's no surprise, right? I think I will be able to use up a couple of more, like, by the time that I actually move, but I just can't extend this out anymore. So realistically, this is it, and I'm done. All right, anyways, let's get into the products that I've used up. And first one, and I said it in my last video, this thing was almost done for, my favorite Holy Grail brow pencil, the Tarte Amazonian Clay Waterproof Brow Pencil in Rich Brown. It's like the best shade match for me. Anyways, there was just a little nub left and it is finally gone. I do love it. I would definitely not mind having it again, but I've really been into my dip brow pomade, especially on my good brow. This, oh God, I swear, no matter what I do, I cannot make this damn brow better. All right, next product I used up a couple of days ago, my Kylie Cosmetics Skin Concealer in the shade Stone. And I am telling you, I got every last bit out that I possibly could because I really enjoy this concealer. I popped the stopper out. I have been scraping and scraping for days, and I can't get any more out of it. It's absolutely no secret, I've said it many times on my channel, I do really, really like this concealer, and it's the only product I've ever tried from Kylie, I think. And it's the only one I'm really interested in trying, to be honest with you. I just can't justify the price. And it's weird because there's concealers at Sephora that I spend essentially the same amount on, but something about giving that money to Kylie kind of like, can't do it. Anyway, so it's a $20 concealer, which is not that crazy in the realm of makeup junkies and what we spend on makeup. But what gets me is their $9 shipping charge. $9. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. I know, I ship shit every day for work. And especially when you're doing high volume, which I know they are. I can't imagine they're spending more than $2 or $3 a parcel to ship an order like this. I just can't imagine it. So they're making bank. They're absolutely making profit on their freight, which there is nothing wrong with. Most companies do. That's pretty significant. $9 is pretty significant to ship one little concealer. So anyways, it just kind of burns me up. All right, last product that I've used up, I just finished this up today and I finally called it quits because it took me like, I damn near bruised my hand up trying to get this foundation out, like banging it on the back of my hand. This was a new addition last month or a couple of weeks ago technically that I added in because I wanted to knock out one more foundation before I moved. This is the e.l.f. Acne Fighting Foundation in the shade Porcelain. And as you can see, I marked it this way, right about there. There was only like a quarter left. It was not a whole lot. But I've been using it incredibly consistently ever since I used up my Wet n Wild Photo Focus and I love it. And actually, I'm gonna miss it. So I'm gonna move on to my Fenty, which I adore and I'm glad to get back to it, but if I find myself missing this, I very well may pick it up, and it's so cheap that I don't have any problem doing that, you know? I do still have the shade left in beige, which is my summer color, which I am kind of tempted to take with me to Hawaii, but I'll probably end up decluttering it, and then if I want it again, I'll pick it up in the future. Okay, you know what? I totally lied. I used up 4 products. I did not see this one sitting here. I don't know what got into me. This makes no sense whatsoever. All right, so actual last product that I used up, Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar Bronze and Glow, just the highlight side. And my God, do I have a story to tell about this one, but as you can see, highlight side is used up. So I have been working my ass off on this product for months. It's taken me like, I don't know, maybe like 7 months consistently working on it. And I didn't think I was gonna use it up at the last update. I'd made great progress. There wasn't a lot left, but it wasn't there. And anyway, so been working on it, thought I was getting close. It was getting a little bit harder to get my brush in, so I decided to repress it. And let me just go ahead and put out a warning PSA for everyone. Perhaps don't try to repress your makeup with Angel Soft toilet paper. It works really well on your bum. It's nice and soft, but I don't think it's really good for makeup. So I have repressed countless products. I've repressed shit all the time. I really enjoy doing it. It makes it easier for me to pick product up. And I've always repressed makeup with toilet paper. Always have. Just go get it out of my bathroom. I never walk downstairs and get paper towels. Always use toilet paper. And I've never had any issues, ever. I did the same thing to Modern Renaissance palette, the shade Burnt Orange, I think. But at the time when I did that one, I just thought I did something wrong. Like I messed it up, I pushed too hard or something like that. It was my fault and I didn't really think much of it. This time I realized it's not my fault. That's just not a good toilet tissue to use. Maybe it's too soft or something, but when I repressed it, that toilet paper just embedded itself into the makeup. It did, like the whole top layer was just solid toilet paper. And it's not like a, oh, let me just like pick it off. It's just, it doesn't work like that. It's just like embedded and stuck in there, and the toilet paper shreds when you try to get it out, and it's just a giant shit show. And so I did take a picture of where I was right before I repressed it. I didn't have a lot of product left. I'm glad that I was able to get my money's worth out of it. I still feel, even though I lost the last little bit of it, I feel like I got my money's worth, so that's fine. But I am kind of disappointed that it ended that way. It was just such a catastrophe, and I was so pissed off at myself because I know I could have finished it up. After repressing it, I was like, oh yeah, I can do this. And Angel Soft had other plans. You know, I think what it is that we usually get toilet paper from Costco or Sam's bulk. We go through a lot of toilet paper in this house. And we were out of toilet paper, so I just like stopped by Kroger, the grocery store, and picked up what was on sale, which was Angel Soft. And I usually don't use it to repress makeup. I've always used like the Costco brand or whatever, and that's held together fine. Maybe their toilet paper is made out of like hay or sawdust or something stiffer. I don't know. Like I said, I like Angel Soft on my bum. Does not work well for makeup. All right, so if you're counting, hopefully better than I am, apparently, I have used up 4 products and I have 4 products left. So I only had 8 in here at the beginning of the month. I had typically always had 10, but there was just no point. There's nothing else I could have added that I was gonna be able to use up. So I just kept it at 8. So let me go ahead and show you the 4 remaining products that I have progress on. All right, first one, this little fucker will not die. So this is an Urban Decay 24/7 eyeliner in the shade Perversion, and this was just a mini to begin with, and I have used the ever-loving shit out of this product, and it just, I mean, I cannot believe it's still hanging on. So hopefully you can see there, I just have a tiny little bit left. I'm even sharpening down into the letters Perversion, but it's still hanging in there. Next, we have my Becca powder, the Soft Light Blurring Powder in the shade Pink Haze. And I was a little bit reluctant to put it in here again for the next month because I knew I wasn't going to use it up, but I thought, what the hell, let me get some more use out of it anyways. And I do have marks on it from last update, so like when I put it in, last update, there's really not a lot of change, at least not visibly enough to mark it again. So I didn't, and that's right about where I'm at. All right, let's talk about my perfume of the month, and then we will do my Modern Renaissance palette, and then we'll be done. All right, so like first time ever that I haven't used up the perfume of the month, because obviously I just put it in here a couple of weeks ago. This is the Juicy Couture Viva La Juicy Sucre, which is the Viva La Juicy base, but a little bit like burnt sugar scent. It's a little bit warmer, kind of wintry. That's why I picked it. Also because it's rather bulky and I didn't want to transport it. I think I might be able to finish this up by the time I actually move. Actually, I feel pretty positive about that. So as of right now, I'm down here. This bottle is incredibly reflective. So I'm down here to what I would consider maybe about a quarter of the bottle left. When I started, I was up to probably about 3/4 of the bottle left. So yeah, I've used up a significant amount. All right, last item, ABH Modern Renaissance Palette. And I've kind of reached my pinnacle with this product. Don't think I'm going to make a lot more progress from here on out, but I'll show you what I've done. So as you can see, these first 6 shades right here, all gone. Those were gone in my last update. So essentially the only thing that I've accomplished in the last couple of weeks has been to use up Antique Bronze, which was one of my favorite shades from this palette. Although I felt like it was kind of deteriorating. Like it lost its luster. You know, it lost its specialness. It wasn't there for me. Anyways, although there is a new shade in the Urban Decay Cherry palette, it's a little bit more purple where this was a little bit more red, but it's very, very similar. I'm excited to use it. Anyway, so hopefully you can see there, I was able to knock out Antique Bronze, and that was like the rest of my original favorite shades from this palette. I do really like Venetian Red now though, but I used up the vast majority of everything that I loved, so I'm good moving on. So I am probably done with this palette. It probably will not go through many more changes from now till the time that you see it next, probably in my declutter. But I will continue to like keep it here. I keep it in the top of my palettes. And, you know, from time to time, if I'm doing a look like today, I have Love Letter on the outer V, I will pull for it. You know, if there's a shade that I want to use or something like that, I'll try to pull it in and make use of it as much as possible. But there's nothing like hardcore that I'm going to go into with like the goal of using it up, because it's just kind of pointless at this point. I'm not going to use anything else up. Anyway, so that's it. 4 down, 4 left. hopefully I can use up that eyeliner and my perfume of the month before I actually leave, in which case you will be updated. You'll know, I guess, in my year-long empties video. Anyway, I just want to say thank y'all so much for like participating and sticking with me through this entire year of this makeup basket project. I've really enjoyed it from what I can see from like the views and comments and everything. It seems like y'all have really enjoyed it. I'm going to be kind of bummed to leave it in the past. I mean, who knows? Maybe I'll pick it back up next year. I don't really know. I'm just going to have to see how my life goes in the future, which is really unlike me. I'm not a see how it goes kind of person. I'm a control everything, that way there are no surprises kind of person. But I'm trying to let go of that little bit of control and see that the world does not come to an end. It doesn't stop spinning. The poles don't melt. Planes don't fall out of the sky if I don't micromanage everything to pieces. Anyways, really getting off topic here. Y'all don't necessarily want to know about my control issues, just saying. All right, y'all, so enough of my rambling for one day. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I hope you stick around for the upcoming declutter. I'm gonna start trying to film maybe in the next couple of days here, even though lighting is so shitty because I have no natural lighting. Anyways, that's a me problem, I know. So that should be coming up in the next week. We can have somewhere in there, so I'm very excited. I will see y'all in a couple of days in my next video. Love y'all.